Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Hare Bol. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Haribo! So you must know well Jatila and Kutila, right? His name is well known. Jatila and Kutila. So here we're talking of Arka Tila. So Maharaj was saying, Japatika Maharaj was saying that this is equal to in Vrindavan Dham, Surya Kunda. So what is the pastime taking place in Surya Kunda? I mean, Arkatila also was discovered by Bhakti-sandarbha Saraswati Goswami Maharaj. It was discovered by him, and now the government is also supporting. Hopefully one day they're going to build a temple for the devotees over there in Arkatila. Haribo! So this is equal to Surya Kunda and Vrindavan. So what's happening is that Jatila, who is mother-in-law, Jatila or Kutila? Jatila. Yeah. So Jatila always wishes good fortune for his son. And what's the son's name? Abhimanyu. So always want fortune, great fortune for his son. And she always requests Radharani to do pujas for the fortune of her husband, yes, of Abhimanyu. Do puja, do all kinds of rituals for the benefit of her son, Abhimanyu. And for that, Purnamasi told Jatila, you know what you should do? You should worship Surya Dev, Surya, Surya Kund. So for that you must worship Surya Dev at Surya Kund. And then Jatila decided, okay, let us go. And when they decided with Radharani, Jatila, Kutila, everybody wanted to go to Surya Kund to worship Surya Dev. So then suddenly some pandit appeared. You know, pandit. Pandit in disguise. And Jatila told a pandit, why don't you come with us? You be the monk, you be the pandit, we'll do puja, Surya puja. Please come. And the pandit said, no, we don't do puja for the benefit of people. We do our own puja. But if you're requesting to do puja for the benefit of the sun will come with you. Will do it. And this pandit has also his disciple, and this disciple was fat disciple. Who is that? Madhubangal. But they were all in disguise, right? Jatila did not know. And who is the pandit? Krishna, Haribo. But they did not know that was Krishna. And then they said, yeah, I will come with you to do puja. Surya puja for your son, for his benefit, for his fortune. Let's go. And then the Panditji monk gave some list what they have to bring and all the ingredients, the saman puja, everything. And they brought everything. And Madhumangal also requested big laddus. And they brought all the saman. And now the puja started. And the Pandit started reciting mantras. But the problem is they don't know how to recite Surya Dev mantra. And they were reciting Krishna mantra. And then Jatila was thinking, what kind of mantra is this? I've never heard this mantra before. You know? And Madhumanga said, no, this is special mantra, rare mantra from the Shastra. This is special mantra, rare mantra from the scriptures. You don't know that, but this is special mantra, will give special benefits, great fortune to your son. So they did the mantras, recitation, and puja was over, and Jatila was satisfied with it. And Jatila gave remunerations, you know, money, dakshina, and then big laddus to Madhumangal. And Madhumangal was very happy with his laddus, you know. So this is how, I just remember that Maharaj was saying about focus. These parikrama actually really is met. Even the gopis, they were doing that. When Krishna, Radharani disappeared, and Krishna disappeared from the Rasa Leela, and they were searching for Radha and Krishna. They did not know Radharani went with Krishna. Krishna disappeared. But when they were going, then they saw the footprints of four footprints, and two footprints belongs to Krishna, the science of Krishna's symbol, and the other two belongs to Srimati Radharani. So that's the verse where they explain that Radharani is never mentioned, is not mentioned in Srimad Bhagavatam, because Sukadeva Goswami, he has only 7 days. If he would be reciting the names of Radharani, he would be unconscious. And here, Sukadeva Goswami has only 7 days. Aradito no, what's the verse? Aradito nonam, right? Indirectly, this verse, Srimati Radharani's name is mentioned. The one who has worshipped Lord Krishna the most, she is that girl who has gone with Krishna. And they saw the four footprints.
Thank you for watching our videos. Be sure to subscribe to our channel. We publish new videos every day. And don't forget to like and share our channel.